you can create a new DNA, RNA, or protein file directly from the Getting Started screen, either from the File menu or by selecting New and choosing your desired file type. For example, select Create a New DNA File, then simply type or paste a sequence into the text field and choose whether it is single-stranded, double-stranded, linear, or circular. SnapGene will automatically detect common features and show a preview of the file. Click Create to create and display the new file. To save your file, click Save and give the file a name. You can open existing files from the top toolbar, the Project side panel, or by clicking the plus button at the top of the screen. If you have a folder containing multiple sequences, you can also open that project folder as a project. The Project side panel displays the folder with all the files it contains listed. Select a file to preview it, or double-click to open in a new tab. Once again, SnapGene will display each file in a separate tab. You can quickly switch between files by selecting the different tabs. You can open many common file types directly in SnapGene. The Import option allows direct access to many online resources. You can select plasmids from the SnapGene online database, choosing from over 2,700 annotated sequences, including all common plasmid cloning vectors. Save them for later, or open them directly into SnapGene. Alternatively, select File to do these tasks from the main SnapGene interface. This includes importing AdGene plasmid sequences or any published sequence from NCBI, UniProt, or Ensemble used at the appropriate accession number. And that's a brief introduction to using files in SnapGene. Watch the rest of the videos in this Getting Started series at snapgene.com to learn more.